day, and welcome to our program. It is our goal to educate you about the work of the Holy Land Foundation for Relief and Development. The Holy Land Foundation is a nonprofit, non-political, 501c3 humanitarian aid and disaster relief organization dedicated to bringing relief to people in need, refugees from both man-made and natural disasters. It is a cause supported solely by donor contributions, receiving no government grants or aid of any kind. The Holy Land Foundation is based in Texas, with offices in Illinois and New Jersey, and overseas in Lebanon, Palestine, and Jordan. In this show, you will learn about our core efforts to aid the Palestinian refugee population in the Middle East, as well as the humanitarian aid which has been provided in Chechnya, Turkey, Kosovo, and here at home in the United States. In our modern world, technology is making life easier for much of the world's population, and it is easy to forget that hundreds of thousands of people of many ethnic backgrounds are suffering as never before. These same people are also being largely left out of the benefits of education that hold the key to the future. With the arrival of a new millennium, we see that human suffering still manifests in the eyes of children. Children of conflict, natural disasters, and political inequities. The Holy Land Foundation for Relief and Development exists to help humankind through human kindness. From the narrow alleys of Gaza, the Rocky Mountains of the West Bank, the refugee camps in Lebanon and Jordan, to volatile regions throughout the world. We are making a difference, but the need is greater than ever before. Donations to the Holy Land Foundation make it possible for us to provide comfort to the most innocent of victims. In this program, the images you will see may be disturbing, because the reality is that there are scores of displaced people in our world who are in dire need of help. Much of the Holy Land Foundation's work is geared to helping the children of calamity, those faces of our collective future who in many cases are in grave danger for their very existence each and every day. You will hear firsthand accounts of the plight of these children and families from the Holy Land Foundation's Emergency Relief Coordinator, a woman whose job is to go immediately to the region of disaster, facilitating the flow of emergency aid as quickly as possible to the people who need it most. But first, a little history. Concerned U.S. citizens of Palestinian descent founded the Holy Land Foundation for Relief and Development in 1989. It was formed in direct response to the devastation of the Palestinian refugee population after intense and prolonged conflicts in the 1980s. After nearly 50 years of confinement, this was the most devastating assault ever on the Palestinian refugees, leaving thousands of orphaned children and widowed mothers in deplorable living conditions. Initially, the foundation provided humanitarian relief to these refugees in Lebanon, Jordan, and Palestine. As our donor base grew, we expanded our scope and now respond to human catastrophes wherever they may occur, man-made or natural. Today, all Holy Land Foundation relief efforts are directed based on donor request, allowing contributors to specifically target their funds to a needy region or to specified categories, including social services, health services, education, and emergency relief. Our donors are very generous people, and we respond directly to their requests. Those requests have led us to the refugee camps in the Middle East, as well as tragedies in Bosnia, Kosovo, and Turkey. Here at home, the foundation has provided relief to disaster victims following flooding in the Midwest, tornadoes in Oklahoma and Texas, and the devastation following the bombing of the Murrah Federal Building in Oklahoma City. Additionally, the Holy Land operates a permanent food bank assisting people domestically from our New Jersey office. The Holy Land Foundation for Relief and Development can be found on the internet at www.hlf.org. Visit the website for current updates on Holy Land relief efforts around the world. Donations online are easy and secure. The website is equipped with the Secure Sockets Layer technology, a powerful encryption protocol that protects data ensuring safety when submitting contributions using credit card or bank information. Log on to hlf.org to learn more and make a donation, or call now to the Holy Land Foundation for Relief and Development at 1-800-909-6822. Now we enter a new era of great advancements in science and technology. Yet every day, 30,500 children under the age of 5 die from preventable diseases. These are senseless deaths caused by a lack of sanitary conditions, access to safe water, and availability of adequate health care. The work of the Holy Land Foundation has intensified as children continue to live in poverty, while our societies experience unprecedented landmarks in wealth and economic prowess. Today, there is a greater need than ever in the refugee camps for basic necessities, food, clothing, housing, and health care. Make the call now to donate to the Holy Land Foundation. Every dollar counts. Our donors come from all ethnic backgrounds, from all walks of life. All are caring individuals who give to the foundation, knowing their contributions are going directly to the regions and people who are in the gravest need. John Bryant, a former United States congressman, now a respected attorney practicing in Dallas, Texas, is well acquainted with the work of the Holy Land. Now, here's John Bryant.
My relationship with the Holy Land Foundation for Relief and Development dates back to 1997. I know them to be very deeply committed to fulfilling the wishes of their donors. And I know the Holy Land Foundation to be an organization of uncommon integrity, with a genuine passion for the difficult task of providing relief to people in need in some of the most difficult situations in the world. From a legal standpoint, the foundation meets and exceeds every legal requirement and every standard for the proper operation of a charitable foundation.
Thank you, John. We realize that there are many charitable organizations out there and many worthy causes. It's important to note that the Holy Land Foundation for Relief and Development is 100% donor financed, taking no government grant or aid of any kind. By remaining solely donor financed, we're able to respond immediately to crisis situations without government red tape dictating what we can or cannot provide. Additionally, we have a commitment of maximum efficiency and financial accountability, consistently maintaining administrative costs to 15%. Over 85% of every dollar donated reaches the people most in need. Administrative costs are kept low by maintaining a small staff worldwide, numbering no more than 35 people. These professionals are supported by hundreds of volunteer workers who give of their time and energy to help the Holy Land Foundation reach out to those in need year in and year out. Dalel Mohammed, the Holy Land Foundation's relief coordinator, first became associated with the foundation as a donor.
The children in Palestine, like children all over the world, here in America, they're dying for a future. They're dying for something to change in their life. They're all hungry for education. They're all hungry for knowledge. The fact that the Holy Land Foundation provides that for them is what brought me in as a donor. These children have a right to education, to life with dignity, and the Holy Land Foundation provides that right to them as much as humanly possible considering the circumstances.
The core of the Holy Land Foundation's work lies with the plight of the Palestinian refugees. More than half of a century of oppressive dispossession has brought with it a terrifying mood of desperation and helplessness. The Holy Land staff, along with a huge roster of loyal volunteers, are working tirelessly to help these people, families, and especially the children, to gain the most basic of human needs, food, shelter, and decent health care.
The children in Palestine are almost a forgotten children, and Holy Land Foundation makes sure they keep their plight in the eye and consciousness of the American public and the world. As Americans, we have a duty to humanity. We have a global duty, and I think we cannot forget about the children in Palestine and how they live and what they don't have. And the Holy Land Foundation is trying to reverse those years of emptiness and give them a future of hope.
Aid provided by your donations to the Holy Land Foundation goes far beyond the immediate day-to-day needs. The foundation is funding hospitals, clinics, and learning institutions. At this clinic in South Lebanon, the doctors are doing all they can, but are constantly overwhelmed by the enormous medical needs of the refugees. This doctor is a dermatologist who is seeing many cases of skin cancer without the necessary room to treat them.
If there is anybody who wants to help us for this center from all over the world, we need a minor surgery room, well complicated, well qualified, well satisfied, in order to give these services for Palestinian peoples, because we have the energy and we have the qualifying services to afford, but we don't have the financial aids to support this center.
Make the call now to donate to the Holy Land Foundation. Every dollar counts. In addition to health care and basic living needs, educational assistance has been a constant priority for the Holy Land Foundation. In this next video segment, we see how your contributions are helping children reach beyond the limitations of their environment towards a better future through education.
It's off to school for these Palestinian children. Like millions of other kids around the world, they go to school dreaming of the future. Unlike so many others, much of their dream has been limited by their own reality. Digging through trash, longing for a safe place to sleep, that's reality for these kids. Education is the only way for them to find a place in the future. Yet tens of thousands of them have no access to basic educational resources. Families who have to make a choice between school for their children or food will ultimately choose food. One in every three refugee children ages 5 to 17 is working and not attending school.
بطلت على اساس ما في مجال اقدر اعيش الا بالطريقه هاي يجون يشتغلوا معي ولا اذا بخلي المدرسه بس بدي اسرع لا اقدر اعيش يطلعوا معلمين ما يطلعوا معلمين مش فراني معي هم ما هم اسرعش انا اعيش يعني ولا يعني مثل مثال كل الشباب هيك هذا نفس العمليه كل طلع اولاد المدارس ما قادرين يعلمون ما في وضع ما في وضع معيش صعب مش غير يعني.
This is where the Holy Land Foundation comes in. The Holy Land Foundation for Relief and Development provides a key to the future for thousands of Palestinians every day. People like this young man with a physical disability, whose father carries him to school on his back because the road to their house is too rocky for the boy to navigate. Without assistance from the Holy Land Foundation, the boy would have no education at all.
إلهي خير غفرانا لقد عادتني روح الروح وعدت اليوم إنسانا بأمسي طالما كنت.
The Holy Land Foundation has made learning possible for thousands of children, nurturing hope for the future. Through generous giving, the foundation provides help in many ways, including financial aid, school supplies, uniforms, and backpacks. Now in Palestine, HLF is operating an education center, opening a door of knowledge to the Palestinian youth. This is the Anwar El Ibrahimi Education Center at Hebron. It is a state-of-the-art facility that is filling the educational gap that exists today. Here, up to 350 students a day benefit from unlimited access to over 10,000 books, with a catalog of titles still growing. Along with access to valuable resources, the center offers classes in basic computer skills and opens the world to the students through internet access. called the Discovery Center. It will give students hands-on experience with science and technology. To ensure longevity of the project, income-generating activities will be implemented, with proceeds going to the operational and growth expenses of the facilities. This project is an investment in the future of the Palestinian people. Despite the horrific conditions that have inhibited the people in the last half century, the youth hold the key to the future. An educated population is the only way to guarantee that future. These children need and deserve much more than just survival. Through education, they'll be able to see and believe in a better future for all. Please help us make these dreams come true today.
The Holy Land Foundation for Relief and Development is an international non-governmental organization. As we said earlier, we receive no government grants or assistance. This is a totally donor-supported cause. Call now, because every dollar counts towards survival for victims of catastrophe, wherever it may strike. As witnessed in dramatic television news reports around the world, war in the breakaway Russian Republic of Chechnya has left the region in shambles. The damage is monumental, both in terms of property and lives lost. The greatest tragedy of all is the thousands of displaced people. An estimated 250,000 people fled Chechnya after massive bombings reduced the capital city of Grozny to rubble. Conditions in the refugee camps here are horrendous, with inadequate shelter, lack of clean water, very little food, and minimal medical assistance. The Holy Land Foundation first began distributing food and supplies to 1,700 families in April of 2000, and now has ongoing operations in several villages along the Chechen-Georgian border. Working with UNHCR, the United Nations High Commissioner on Refugees, the Holy Land Foundation is providing food, water, medical and educational support for thousands daily.
Currently, our operations are feeding 10,000 families. These people have nothing. They're living in old pre-Soviet barracks with no electricity, no running water, and clearly no food. We're providing them with enough food and hygiene products to sustain them for 1 month. That $1 that is donated is able to feed a family of six in Chechnya for one day, a family of six.
The Holy Land Foundation is the only U.S.-based non-governmental organization providing relief to the region and has gained the trust of the Chechen government and people. So much tragedy has happened here, but the most important element of recovery could be simple: hope for the future. When devastation of this magnitude strikes, the people at the bottom are left with nothing but despair. The Holy Land Foundation is committed to helping these people gain a foothold in life, but it will obviously be a difficult struggle for years to come.
They're by themselves, and they don't understand why. They all cry to me and tell me why is nobody coming to our rescue? These people are going to need long-term solutions when the war ends, and Holy Land hopes to assist them, just as we do in Palestine. Providing long-term solutions, because you have an entire population there too who has no breadwinner, who has no male figure, and they're orphaned and they're widowed. Chechnya is a very sad place. It's very, very sad because no one's there. And they're people, they're part of humanity. And that's how we work. Wherever there's a need, and Chechnya, there's definitely a need.
Make the call now to donate to the Holy Land Foundation. Every dollar counts. Wherever, whenever disaster strikes, the Holy Land Foundation for Relief and Development responds based on the wishes of you, our valued donors. In 1999, a catastrophic earthquake measuring 7.4 on the Richter scale struck Turkey with devastating results. More than 17,000 people were killed, and some 285,000 homes were destroyed. This massive destruction left an entire population injured and homeless. Contributors to the Holy Land Foundation responded immediately, with funds to be spent in assisting the enormous Turkish refugee population.
There was so much death and destruction everywhere. I had never seen anything like that. Every building in Adapazarı, in İzmit, every building was collapsed. When we were there, they were still retrieving people.
With the Turkish people as our volunteers, the Holy Land Foundation worked in concert with the International Red Cross and Red Crescent to provide a wide array of relief support to the people. Tent cities were set up to provide shelter for as many victims as possible. The foundation brought in 80 tons of medical equipment and supplies and set up mobile clinics in multiple spots throughout the earthquake zone. Additional medical supplies, bandages, sterile gowns, and medicines were provided for clinics already set up in the tent cities. Within 4 days, the foundation had hot food kitchens established, feeding three meals a day to an endless line of displaced, starving people.
The Turkish people helped us tremendously. They all volunteered. We all worked around the clock, nonstop, for over 2 weeks. How could you sleep when you know these people were living in the street? And we didn't sleep. We took shifts. We'd sleep in trucks. We'd sleep on the street. We just took shifts just to make sure that we could do anything we can to comfort these people. And I think we were quite successful.
Make the call now to donate to the Holy Land Foundation. Every dollar counts. In 1999, the eyes of the world gazed with disbelief at the plight of the people of Kosovo after a horrific episode of ethnic cleansing, followed by 11 weeks of NATO airstrikes. 800,000 people crossed the border into Albania, a humanitarian crisis of enormous proportions.
When you arrived on the ground, every corner had refugees just sitting there where they had walked, some for 8 days. With their children, every family, minimum 6 to 8 children. Everyone sitting with their feet bandaged and wrapped and hungry and crying, and everybody had the look of fear.
Do you have all your relatives, all your family are with you?
I get chief njerëz të tuaj të afërmit, I get me vetë.
I pam vetëm një në mundur një familjës, ato që ka vrë.
So, the majority of my relatives and my family are here. We missed two that were killed there.
They were killed?
Kam vrë. Yeah, they were killed.
It was an urgent, desperate situation. The Holy Land Foundation began immediately working with the Albanian people in assembling tent cities, bringing in food, clothing, and medical supplies. The foundation worked side by side with two other relief organizations in a tent city housing 10,000 people. Because of the sheer numbers of displaced people, there was a shortage of bread available to feed them. The Holy Land Foundation responded by purchasing a mobile bakery and 1,000 tons of wheat flour. It was a logistical feat to get the bakery and the flour into the camps, but through the persistence of the Holy Land staff and help from the NATO Royal Dutch Army and Marines, it was accomplished. Assessing needs and then providing aid in an efficient manner. That's what the Holy Land Foundation does best.
We started pumping out 10,000 loaves of bread every 8-hour period. And giving it to the Kosovars, it was a very, very big need, and it was based strictly on assessment, and that's the only way we operate.
Make the call now to donate to the Holy Land Foundation. Every dollar makes a difference to the refugees of the world. In Kosovo, as in all areas of Holy Land operation, our support remains in place long after the initial crisis. The Holy Land Foundation has since donated the mobile bakery to the people of Kosovo, and it continues operation in the capital city of Pristina. Additionally, two mobile health clinics and other vital support from Holy Land remain in Kosovo and will stay in place as long as there is a need and as long as we continue to have donor support for our programs. Thank you for joining us for this look at the important work of the Holy Land Foundation for Relief and Development. Remember, this is a nonprofit, wholly donor-supported cause. Every dollar you give makes an enormous impact on the lives of the refugees of the world. The Holy Land Foundation can only provide these services and continue their programs through your kind support. So, give of your heart and give today. You can make a difference. Thank you.